Stand by for action. We are about to launch Stingray.
Why? It's in color.
Yes, m'lady. Something facilitated by Mr. Grade's do.
You mean Lord Grade of Elstree, Parker?
Quite, m'lady. Incidentally, Hold Lose Cash changed everything for HP Films.
We moved from Ipswich Road to Stirling Road on the Slough Trading Estate in 1963.
That's where it all really took off.
Greenville, I am bombing battle station. Anything can happen in the next half hour.
We had more money, we had more time.
The sheer luxury of a large building.
We had everything that we ever dreamed of.
I thought that was the beginning of something special.
Stingray was a submarine which could go to great depths. This is how they discovered a race of beings that were living underwater.
Because we've been everywhere, if you think about it, so we thought it was time we went with our characters underwater.
They were based at Marineville, where we had Commander Shaw in charge.
And they are essentially defending the planet from Titan, who is an evil undersea overlord, or underlord, I guess you'd say. The main craft there is Stingray, which is piloted by Troy Tempest and Phones, and they're ably assisted by the dumb but beautiful Aquamarina.
It became a jokey thing in the end, of course, with a woman that doesn't speak.
One of the girls in the control room was called Atlanta. Those two were both in love with Troy Tempest, lucky old Troy Tempest.
Commander Shore, Lieutenant, Atlanta. Meet Marina, the latest recruit to the World Aquanaut Security Patrol.
Marina, well, what do you know?
Yeah, well, as I were saying, at least we know what we're up against.
Well, I certainly know what I'm up against.
I was very pleased to be part of the Stingray process because I understand that it was the first series to be done in England that was done entirely in color.
While we were in America, we saw color for the first time, and it just knocked us out. And we said, we've got to do our next series in color.
It had no shelf life if you made it in black and white. The whole world was going to turn to colour.
Kodak managed to produce a single strip of film, which could be exposed like any other film. And when it was developed and printed, it came out in colour. And that meant suddenly that it was possible for us, who were making television pictures, to make them in colour.
But of course we had to talk to Lou Grade again. So we came back home, saw Lou Grade, and said, Lou, you've got to do our next series in colour.
Being cautious, as I've always been, I sent Reg Hill to the American networks where they had been shooting colour.
Phones, watch what you're doing with that paint.
Oh, sorry, Troy.
And when he come back, we'll have a little chat on stage and we go, right, mate, got to be flat. Everything's got to be lit flat. Flat, flat, flat. No shadows, flat.
Can't use that colour, right? Repaint it. Can't use deep greens like that. Reds are out, it bleeds, you know. And so I said, we had to tear all the sets apart and rebuild them.
That colour looks great, Atlanta.